Okay, here we go. A little talk about what's going on here with the shells these days. We know that there are some funny things going on with shells. And this one here, I'm going to show you what I'm planning on doing with my Winda brand from Panda Fireworks. Panda Designs 2018. So yeah, these are the new ones, and they've got a brocade crown with pearls, palm trees, and with strobes, ball shells that say what? Shoots flaming balls with reports. Yeah, right. Is that what they call crackle report? I don't know, but anyway, just to talk about this. And the things that are going on with that. So they've got an excuse, and some people are accepting it that these are so. Oh, you can put them in your standard 1¾-inch launchers. Well, yeah, that's kind of true. But the number one reason why they do that is because they want you to think that you're buying a ball shell. So, anyway. But, and I bought this kit just to find out for sure on this brand that this one is artillery shells from Panda, Winda, from Panda. The Winda kit is these. So okay, I've got I actually took all of these off, and they will work. I know how to deal with it. I haven't looked inside to see how much lift charge space there's in there. There might be about that much, I'm guessing, and then clay, and then all you're really winding up is maybe 1 inch of space in here that's holding composition for your show, for the display when it breaks. So what I'm gonna do is I'm still gonna use this. I'll use it in my finale for next year, 2017, but I will do it in flights of and using spent cake. And this is something I want to show everybody, and I've kind of done this thing before for people. Demonstrated this kind of thing with a boombox and so on and so forth. But that's the idea. They do fit in there pretty good. Remember when you gotta push that, in this case, you gotta push that down all the way. And I can feel the bottom right now with my finger. There it is. It's a little tight, but I'll consider that the fuse, when it's burnt, it'll be gone, so there'll be plenty of space for that and plenty of back pressure for that thing to go. These are kind of irregular, you know, this is kind of oval here and stuff, but I only need six of these to do the job. Yeah, I'll add this into my finale. Maybe do some other things too. I think some actual ball shells. I've got multicolored ball shells that are legitimate 1¾-inch. So, but this is the idea I want people to think about. If they find a good deal on these things, you know, go ahead, pick them up. Yeah, they are. And they'll probably look nice. There'll probably be some flash breaking, you know, to make it look like it's a bigger spread, but it's going to be thin. Because it just can't fit a lot of comp in here. Okay. Yeah, give it a try. I'm gonna load this thing up and then. Do it that way from an old this one's an old one, an old Winda Funny Holiday, which really wasn't all that great of a cake, but Wenda does normally. You know, they do a lot of great stuff, but every once in a while, yeah. But a lot of crackle in this one is what it did. It was a crackle cake, if you want to crackle, anyway. I don't even know if they still make Funny Holiday or not, but that's my point. And also to say that on my channel, I've been doing this kind of thing on my channel, on my YouTube channel here since 2011. I'm still kind of a newbie on YouTube, so to speak, 2011. But I've been doing fireworks since professional fireworks in professional for since 1992. Well, 92 is when I first started selling fireworks. 95, I stopped, and then I became a PGI member, and also joined a fireworks club, and did a lot of pyro experimentation, which in a fireworks club is a great thing to do. I mean, that's what you, in a fireworks club, that's what you do. You experiment when you're not shooting professional shows, which we did about 12 to 15 shows a year. It would vary, but and I would be at just about every single one of them, every one that I could. Anyway, that's it. Just to tell you about a little bit about me and a little bit about trying something to deal with these. Now, regular I like it when they're honest and say that they're regular. They don't always say right on the covered. You know, their boxes are covered and they don't even tell you. They just say artillery shells, but that is a shell, you know, that's an artillery shell without a ball or not. But you can, I like the ones that are honest and they let you see that you're actually getting a canister shell rather than a ball. And this is 1 inch. It's a pretty good roundness, and I've seen smaller ones that are more like 3/4 inch. And that's even less. That can't be good. But at least this one's 1 inch. This is a 1 inch. So, I'd say that's taking up three quarters there. Yeah, that's about 1 inch. I should be out here with a ruler, but I bet that's one. Talk to you later. Take care, everybody, and put your money in the air.